the original honky tonk train. I'm the one that you see when you're watching a western. That's me chugging by. I'm the one that you see in the films on the western. I tell you why, cause no other lover can ever compare with the places I've been, cause I've been everywhere and I never once stopped for a moment of resting. And if the fire's burning properly, the heart and order rise and go along a lot of tubes that are surrounded by water, onto the boiler till eventually it moves on down the engine's aorta, and through a funnel where a cloud of smoke exudes. And now the hot air in the tubes has made the water in the boiler turn to steam. Hot, hot, hot. And the steam also rises and collects inside that large symbolic dome at the top. Top, top. But if you think that now the steam is just as hot as it is gonna get, you're wrong, cause it's not, not, not. Because this is where the driver opens up the regulator valve handle. The steam becomes alive again and goes back through the boiler or can, which I call it only cause I've a shortage of rhymes ending in an. So having it through the superheated tube, the steam's is hotter than ever it was before. The steam is more, you may be sure. The steam now passes on into the piston cylinder. It pushes the pistons forwards and backwards on means of valves which reciprocate in alternation according to simple mechanical law. The piston then pushes connecting rods fixed to the wheels that are set on the rails. But that's not the end of the story, cause then all that steam, as you will have seen, is blown out as exhaust through the funnel where it can expire, thereby increasing the draft of the fire. So now apart from some rather superfluous detail, which doubtless you will seem obvious and hardly worth saying, the story's over, it's basically essential, the rest is merely overlay. And you can see for yourself quite easily, although I would just like to mention the thing on the front, which always comes in handy when you want to catch cows.